From the menu bar on the left, click on Employees from Payroll. Click on Create New Employee. The New Employee window opens. There are five different types of employee details, namely primary details, contact details, payment details, onboarding details, and notes. Remember that the fields in red are mandatory. Enter the employee first and last name with appropriate salutation from the drop-down list. Here, let's say Miss Oprah Robinson. You can choose the display name from the list of suggestions. This name is used throughout Gov reports to represent the particular employee. Enter the date of birth. Choose the residency status from the drop-down. It can be one among resident, non-resident, or working holiday maker. In this case, let it be resident. The employment status can be chosen from the list of options. Here, Ms. Oprah Robinson is a full-time employee of Rosina Private Limited. The payment type can be chosen from the drop-down. For example, select salary and wages. The employment basis can be chosen. In this case, the first option, individual non-business, is selected. The employee number field is set to auto as it assigns a unique number internally to identify the employee. Contact details like email and address is important. Enter the street name and select the city from the list of options. The rest of the address fields, including state, PIN code, and the country, gets filled automatically. The payment details have a mandatory field, currency. This is by default set to AUD Australian dollar. In addition to this, the account number, BSB number, and account name can also be entered. This section contains all the necessary information for making a payment to employees. The next section is onboarding details. Click on the checkbox to fill the employee onboarding details. The onboarding details are a one-time setup when the employee joins the company. As soon as the checkbox is clicked, the onboarding details form extends on the same window. Select the occupation code from the lists of job roles. Get a declaration that the above given details are correct from the employee and save the employee details. The notes section can have any additional employee information for internal use. Once saved, you can see the employee name listed under the list of employees.